number one source for games, fun, and a lot of puns. I'm your host, Gina Donovan, and it's time to put on your business suits and get your sales face on, because we're about to spin on into our very first episode of The Office, and it's a spin, not a twirl. Get it? Did anybody get that pun? Okay, I'm glad. So. I was really nervous. It was the first thing that came to my mind. Anyway, this is going to be a very special episode of Rowan Roulette, because instead of our usual two contestants, we are upping the ante and having a tournament style with four contestants. So let's meet our first two. On my left, we have Adriana. Adriana, how hype are you right now?
I am so hype. I love The Office to death. It's one of my favorite shows ever, so.
Such a quality show.
It is.
Words can't describe the love.
It's true. It's very true.
On my right, we have Jimmy. Jimmy, how excited are you right now to be on the
show? I am very pumped. Always good to be on the other side of the camera. So, usually I'm behind, but yeah, I'm excited. Office, great show.
Yes, it's going to be an awesome show. Are you guys excited? You're on our very first tournament style episode.
I am.
Are you nervous? Like, you don't even know how good the other contestants are yet.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
I am a little nervous, yes.
Anything can happen. You want to just jump right into our first round?
Yep. Let's do it.
Alrighty. This first round consists of trivia. I will read you a trivia question and four possible answer choices. The first person to buzz in with the correct answer after I've finished reading all the answer choices will earn 2 points. However, if he or she answers incorrectly, the other contestant will have his or her chance to steal for half the points, earning a total of 1 point. And when you hear this sound, the round will be over. You guys ready to go?
Yep.
Yep.
Alrighty, let's jump right into it. Which of the following actors does not share their name with their character? A, Creed, B, Oscar, C, Phyllis, or D, Michael?
It is Phyllis.
Phyllis is incorrect.
Really?
For the steal.
Oh, sorry, Oscar.
Oscar's incorrect. It's Michael. His name's Steve Carell.
Oh, I didn't hear Michael.
I thought that was a gimme one. I tried to start it easy for you guys.
Oh my God.
I don't even know where this is going to go from here now. Let's see. Question number two. What was the name of Pam's first fiance? A, Evan, B, Roy, C, Stanley, or D, Tom?
Roy.
Roy is correct. That's okay. Just got to get a little quicker on the buzzer. Mm-hmm. Let's go to question number three. Anything can happen, guys. This is getting intense. How much money does Michael donate to Oscar's walkathon before he knew it was per mile? A, $10, B, $15, C, $20, or D, $25?
25.
25 is correct. Did you just know that off the top of your head?
Yeah.
Dang, I did not know that one. That takes skill. Did you know that one too? Dang, you guys are too good already. Maybe I can trip you up here. What do they call the third grade class to which Michael promises college tuition? A, Scott's Tots, B, Michael Stars, C, College Kids, or D, Michael's Kids?
Scott's Tots.
Scott's Tots is correct. Just gotta hit that buzzer the second I finish. Mm-hmm. It's okay, we got time to catch up, we're good. Question number five, what song was played at Pam and Jim's wedding as everyone dances down the aisle? A, Fire Burning by Sean Kingston, B, Forever by Chris Brown, C, Take On Me by Aha, or D, The Wedding March? Jimmy.
Forever.
Forever is correct. There you go. So you're getting on the board. You got this. Alrighty. Question number six. Where do Michael and Jan go on vacation? A, Bermuda, B, Jamaica, C, Puerto Rico, or D, the Bahamas?
Jamaica.
Jamaica is correct. But remember, hit the buzzer after I finish.
Oh, yeah,
I give everyone one gimme there. So you had your one. Alrighty. Question number seven. Who speaks the first line of the series? A, Dwight, B, Jim, C, Michael, or D, Pam? I think, try it again. Okay, Jimmy, I couldn't remember.
All right, I'm gonna say Michael?
Michael is correct.
Yay.
You are right, Michael Scott, first line of the series. Is that what you were gonna guess too?
Yeah.
No?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay. Okay, I was gonna say, good thing you didn't get it, but now it's sad, I'm sorry. Alrighty, question number eight. Who delivers the final line of the series? A, Dwight, B, Jim, C, Michael, or D, Pam?
I think it's Pam.
Pam is correct.
All right.
There you go. Look at you. You're getting back up. Alrighty. But there's still time to catch back up. Question number nine. From where does Michael think Times Square got its name? A, Time Magazine. B, The New York Times. C, There's a Really Big Clock. Or D, Because All of the Good Times Happen There. Ooh, stumped.
I'm gonna guess New York Times. I think that's wrong, though. I'm gonna
say... That was a good guess, but it is wrong.
Wait, what was the question again?
Where does he think Times Square got its name? A, Time Magazine, B, New York Times.
There's a really big clock.
Also good guess, but incorrect. It's because all the good times happen there. Very Michael Scott-ism right there. But it's okay, mm-hmm. We got more. Question number 10, Jim's roommate thinks he made up one of his coworkers. Which coworker is it? A, Creed, B, Kevin, C, Dwight, or D, Michael?
Dwight.
Dwight is correct. He didn't actually believe that Dwight was real, and honestly, I don't think I would either.
No.
He's a character. Alrighty, question number 11. Oh, what is the name of Michael Scott's movie? And if you guys don't get this, I'm just, mm-hmm. I'm done, I'm out. A, Clean Up on Aisle 12, B, Threat Level Midnight, C, Michael Scott, Paper Hero, or D, From Salesman to Hitman. There we go.
Threat Level Midnight.
Threat Level Midnight is correct. I was going to say, if nobody got that, I was going to be really sad. Like, such an iconic movie. That should be.
It's funny.
Oscar
we were just talking award. About that
That's
before
the
show.
That's actually the best movie in the entire world, so.
Mm-hmm. Literally, out of anything made ever, like.
No, it really is.
He should. I can't even deal. Alrighty, mm-hmm. Question number 10. What is not a name Michael Scott gives himself while he is giving blood? A, human juice box, B, type ocean spray, C, Hawaiian blood punch, or D, reverse vampire?
Reverse vampire.
Reverse vampire is correct. Was that a guess or did you just know it?
No, like all the other ones were recognizable. That one wasn't.
Yeah, we tried our best. Mm-hmm. We tried our best to imitate it. Was that what you were going to say
too?
Yeah,
that's okay. What I was going to say.
It's okay. At least we know it. Alrighty, question number 13. What is Meredith's last name? A, Anderson, B, Martin, C, Breton, or D, Palmer? Jimmy.
Palmer.
Palmer is correct. There we go. There we go. Alrighty. Question number 14. Why does Pam refuse to go to sporting events? A, she was once forgotten at a hockey game by a date. B, she hates sports. C, she got hit in the head with a foul ball at a baseball game. Or D, her first boyfriend broke up with her at a high school football game.
A.
A is correct. She got left at a game by a date, and who was it?
Roy.
Mm-hmm. See, that should have been flag number one, Pam. And that is the end of our round, guys. That was super intense. Are you ready to hear who is moving on to the third and final round?
Yep.
It is Adriana. Yep. Mm-hmm. Jimmy, thank you for coming on
thank
the show. You did
Sorry,
a great
Jimmy.
Job.
Thank
that
you.
Is the end of round one. We have Adriana, and she winning it, and she totally channeled her inner Dwight and beat the competition. Stay tuned for round two to meet our next two contestants and see how they do. Welcome back. We just finished our first round of this tournament-style episode of Rowan Roulette, and things are about to get crazier than Kelly as we welcome our next two contestants and see which of them will come out on top and head on to the third round. So let's meet them. On my left, we have Sean. Sean, how hype are you to be on our first tournament episode of Rowan
Super hype.
Super hype. I see your shirt. Show the camera your shirt.
Yeah, woo! True Farms.
Yes, True Farms. Beautiful. You came ready,
ready to
go. And on my left, we have Ellie. You guys like inadvertently coordinated here?
Of course.
I like it. Do you like both work for True Farms?
Of course. Yep. I am a full-time manager employee.
Oh.
Course.
I like it. Very impressive. Ellie, how pumped are you to be here today?
I wish I was as pumped as this guy over here.
I believe in you.
I'm really pumped,
get
though.
Pumped.
You, get pumped. If we have all the time to get pumped into our first round. No, our second round, but your first round. I'm confusing myself. Are you guys ready to just get into it?
Yeah.
Before we all get really confused. Alrighty, this round is going to go exactly like our first round. I will read you a trivia question and four possible answer choices. The first person to buzz in with the correct answer after I've finished reading all the possible answers will earn 2 points. However, if he or she answers incorrectly, the other contestant will have his or her chance to steal for half the points, earning a total of 1 point. And when you hear this sound, the round will be over. Are you guys pumped?
Woo.
Are you more pumped now that you know the rules?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Okay, let's jump right into it and waste no time. Question number one. In the pilot episode of The Office, who is starting their first day at the company? A, Aaron, B, Ryan, C, Kelly, or D, Pam? I give everyone a gimme. I said this earlier. Ellie?
No, let him take it.
That's your one gimme.
No, I don't want it.
Okay, Sean.
Ryan.
Ryan is correct. Ellie, I was giving you
I'm
your
sorry.
Gimme. It's okay. We have more questions. Question number two. Which of the following characters does not work in accounting? A, Meredith, B, Angela, C, Oscar, or D, Kevin? Sean.
Meredith.
Meredith is correct. Is that what you were going to say too? It's okay. See, first you were too early, now you're too late. You're going to get it.
You got to find a good middle.
Right. It takes time to do it.
Sean is a vet, a Rowan vet here. So he knows what he's doing, but it's okay. We have more. Question number three. According to the Schrute family rules, what happens if you do not learn all of your rules by age 5? A, you will be disowned. B, you will have to live outside for a year. C, you cannot eat beets until you are 28. Or D, you will be eaten in your sleep. Sean.
D.
D is correct. Dang, you know your, well, I should have known you know your Schrute rules.
Come on, let's go. All day family. Long.
Ellie, you knew it too?
Yep.
Say, because you're a part of the Schrute. You guys color coordinated.
Color coordinated. We came in.
I feel a little bit sad I'm out of the loop here.
It's got some red.
You're like watered down beets.
I'm like watered down beets. Like some sort of like beet. Like kind of juice or something.
Yeah.
I don't know.
We can't be disgracing beats on the air.
We're just gonna go to question number four. Which of the following is not one of Michael Scott's self-proclaimed flaws? A, occasionally he hits someone with his car. B, he volunteers too much. C, he works too hard. Or D, he sings in the shower. Ellie.
B.
B is incorrect for the steal.
D.
D is also incorrect. It was C. He works too hard.
Oh, really?
Yes. Well, I almost forgot the answer myself. I thought you were right. I thought it was he sings in the shower, but it is not. He works too hard. Dang it, Michael Scott. Hard life.
Hard life.
What a terrible flaw. Alrighty, question number five. In the episode Company Picnic, which branch found out they were closing? A, Scranton, B, Stanford, C, Nashua, or D, Buffalo? Sean.
Buffalo.
Buffalo is correct. Already question number six. Where did Andy go to college?
Oh,
and
this
again,
is good.
If you guys don't get this, I'm just gonna cry
a
little bit.
This is one of those gimme ones. You gotta get this one.
Everybody better get it. A, Cornell, B, Yale, C, Harvard, or D, Princeton? Sean.
A, Cornell.
A, Cornell is correct. Ellie, so close. You just got it like a half a second late. Gotta like beat, well, don't beat the buzzer, but like.
Yeah, you gotta have the whole experience.
Wait, no, you should
the buzzer.
Beat the buzzer.
Okay.
It's like all about beats. Reflexes.
Like beats, no, nobody got it? Okay. See, there we go. Now again, it took us a minute. Alrighty, question number seven. What did Angela give Creed for Christmas during the episode Classy Christmas? A, deodorant, B, a comb, C, a toothbrush, or D, a bar of soap? Ellie!
D, a bar of soap?
So close, but no. Good guess. Sean.
A, deodorant.
A, deodorant is correct. Oh, you were so close. Deodorant and soap, they're so similar.
That's my favorite.
We're already hyped for this one. Question number eight. How did Michael hurt his foot? A, he stepped on a fork. B, he tripped while running away from a squirrel. C, he burns it on a George Foreman grill. Or D, he kicked a stone he thought was a bouncy ball. Ellie.
He stepped on a George Foreman grill.
Yes! Yes, Ellie! Get it on the board!
Oh,
yes,
man.
I love it! Alrighty, question number nine. What is Michael's middle name? A, Gregory, B, Gary, C, Gus, or D, it is never said?
B, Gary.
B, Gary is correct. Dang, you know
Michael Gary Scott.
See, I thought, was Garrett an option? Maybe I made that up. I was gonna say I thought it was that, but it's not.
That's
You're
Gary.
Right. Okay, we're just gonna keep going. Stop confusing myself. Question number 10. What is Aaron's real first name? A, Sasha, B, Pam, C, Angie, or D, Kelly? Ellie.
D, Kelly.
D, Kelly is correct. There you go. So you're getting the hang of the buzzer. I like it. Alrighty, question number 11. What is the only Christmas song Andy learned on the sitar? A, The Little Drummer Boy. B, Oh Come All Ye Faithful, C, Jingle Bells, or D, Deck the Halls?
Is it A?
A is incorrect for the steal.
C, Jingle Bells?
Also incorrect,
it's
a good guess.
I know, it's probably D, isn't it?
It's D, Deck the Halls.
That was my second guess.
It's okay, that was a tough one.
Wow.
Alrighty, question number 12. What is the name of Michael's nephew that comes to intern at the office? A, Larry, B, John, C, Mason, or D, Luke? Sean.
It's Luke.
Luke is correct. Oh my God. Was that what you were going to say too? Dude, you guys are too good. I like had to like look up half of these answers and I love this show. Alrighty, question number 13. How did Michael originally get hired at Dunder Mifflin? A, he followed a girl to the office park and left with a job. B, his uncle got him into the company. C, he started as an intern but never left. Or D, it was either Dunder Mifflin or Staples.
C, he was an intern and never left.
So close, but incorrect. For the steal.
What were the options again?
Let's go back over our options. It was A, He followed a girl into the office park.
Is it
and
A?
And left with, yes, it is A.
Oh,
it is
really?
A, there
oh.
you go. He followed a girl into the
I
office.
I forgot he was that creepy.
Left with a dog. Yep, that's Mike, what's up for you? And that was an intense round, guys. You both did so good.
Oh, I want to answer 14.
To hear who is going to the next round. Are you pumped?
I'm pumped.
Our winner for the next round, not the winner, just for the round, is Sean. Yes, Sean, Ellie, thank you so much for coming on this episode.
Thank you for having
you
me.
You did great. It looks like that's the end of round two. Sean will be moving on to our third and final round. Stay tuned to see if he will become the regional manager of this episode or just an assistant to her. Welcome back. We're about to head into our third and final round of this The Office-themed episode of Rowan Roulette, and I'm more excited than Angela when she gets a new cat. Let's check in with our contestants and see how they're feeling before we begin. How are you guys feeling?
Great.
We have Sean and Adriana,
yeah.
two winners of round one and two. How pumped are you? I mean, you should already feel accomplished because you made it this far.
I'm super pumped.
Things are about to get
That's true.
Cray.
I'm pumped too.
Yeah.
We're all pumped.
I'm pumped as well.
Pump, 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 pump. Pump, pump.
We're just pumped.
I love Sean.
Yeah.
I'm glad there's no, like, hardcore hatred rivalry going on right
no.
now, but things
no,
are going
to
get
worse.
Sean's too good of a person for me to hate.
Oh, thank you, Adriana, you as well. We
I
do
like
have
this.
Rivalry on the show, but
that's true.
It's nice, fun rivalry, which we both enjoy.
Yeah. I like it. It's like a Jim Dwight thing. You really like each other, but you're going to...
Yeah. We're going to see how it seems. What call are we going out after this? We're going to hit all the tri-state areas. Rowan's paper supplier, it's about to change, so...
It's about to change.
You know that.
To what? Is it Shroot Farms? Do they supply paper
no,
now?
No, Dunder Mifflin. I work for Dunder Mifflin.
Oh, you work for Dunder Mifflin.
Now, if you want beets, I'll give you the hookup. Or you want to get, you know, stay in a bed, some bed and breakfast, meet my cousin Mo.
I was about to say, can we meet Mo's?
Yeah, meet your cousin Mo's.
Okay, I'm down. Yeah. I want to meet Mo's.
Well, like, Mo's is a good guy,
spend
you know?
A day with Mo's. Okay, guys. Are you ready to start this round?
Let's do it.
Yes.
Alrighty. For this round, we are bringing back another Rowan Roulette classic. Who said it? I will read a line of dialogue said by one of the characters on the show. Your job, name the character who said it. The first person to buzz in with the correct answer will earn a total of 2 points. However, if he or she answers incorrectly, the other contestant will have his or her chance to steal for an extra point, earning a total of 3 points. Are you guys ready
yeah.
to go?
Yes.
Everything's Woo. On the line. Alrighty, let's get right into it. Question number one. I just want you to know that you can't just say the word bankruptcy and expect anything to happen. Adrian.
Oscar.
Oscar is correct. It's okay. Just gotta
We're good.
Get, you had your buzzer on point last
oh,
round.
Yeah, you know, we're good.
It's okay, we can get back into it. Alrighty, quote number two. In your wildest fantasy, you are in hell and you are co-running a bed and breakfast with the devil.
Michael.
Michael was a good guess, but incorrect for the steal and the extra point.
Jim.
Jim is correct.
Yeah.
You are totally correct.
That
he was sassing Dwight. Because what else does Jim really do already? Question number three. There's too many people on this earth. We need a new plague. That was a tie, so we're going to go into our Rowan Roulette rock, paper, scissors. All right. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Alrighty, Sean.
And that is going to be Dwight.
That is Dwight. You are right. Is that what you were going to say, too?
Of course.
Obviously.
Okay.
The first one, the first part of it could have been up to anywhere, but as soon as you said plague,
plague,
you know it was going to be.
You got to know. That is a Dwightism right there. Alrighty, let's see quote number four, if you can get this one. Just pretend we're talking until the cops leave. Adriana.
Creed
is correct. Best character on the show.
Best character on the show.
Oh, he's just, he's such a weirdo, and I love it. Alrighty, question number five, or quote number five. I'm not superstitious, but I am a little stitious. Adriana.
Michael.
Michael is correct. Dang, you know your quotes over there. Yeah. Alrighty, quote number six. I should really have a Twitter account. Adriana.
Dwight.
Oh my gosh, you were going over there. Did you know that one too?
I did, but she got it first.
Dang, you are just good at this already. Quote number seven. In any cheating movie, the person getting cheated on is the hero.
I'm going to have to go Michael on that one.
That was a good guess. This character is talking to Michael.
Darn, I thought it was.
Andy?
Andy is correct! Because then, from that, he goes, I am Beyonce always. Alrighty, quote number eight. Sometimes I'll start a sentence and I don't even know where it's going. I just hope I find it along the way.
That's Michael.
That is Michael, you are correct. That I love that quote so much, it's just so, I can't. Alrighty, quote number nine. I want people to be afraid of how much they love me. I think that was another tie. Back to the rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Okay, rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Alrighty, Adriana.
Michael.
Michael is correct. How deep of Michael already? Quote number 10. Fact, bears eat beets. Bears, beets. Battlestar Galactica. Adriana.
Jim.
Jim is correct. I thought we were going to trip you up on that one. Scream Dwight. Was that, did you know Jim, or were you going
to
get
I knew Jim. That was Jim. That's the most, that has to be the most famous quote on the
that
show.
That is the most famous quote of the show. I was hoping, since he was impersonating Dwight, it might be a little iffy, but I should have known. You guys are way too good already. Quote number 11. Saw Inception. At least I dreamt I did. Adriana.
Michael.
Michael is correct. Quote number 12. Blink once if you want me to pull the plug. Adriana.
Michael.
Michael is incorrect for the steal.
Man, blink once if you want me to pull the plug. Dwight.
Dwight is correct. It's when Meredith got rabies.
That is when she got rabies.
Oh, this one's good.
Alrighty. Quote number 13. You're paying way too much for worms, man. Who's your worm guy? Sean.
That's Creed.
That is Creed. Iconic character already. Quote number 14. There's such a thing as good grief. Just ask Charlie Brown.
I'm going to have to go Aaron. Is that Aaron?
Aaron was a good guess, but incorrect.
That is a very...
Andy?
It seems like an Aaron or an Andy quote, but both are incorrect. It was actually Michael.
Really? Somehow. Because I was thinking it's someone of a very immature kind of scenario.
That would have been a good guess, though. I probably would have gone with, like, Aaron.
I knew this quote was coming up.
Alrighty. Quote number 15. Sometimes I feel like everyone I work with is an idiot. And by sometimes, I mean all times. Sean.
Kevin.
Kevin is correct.
I don't mean to be terrible, but that quote wasn't finished. But it is
yes, Kevin. Yes, every of the time. I missed the last line. You were totally correct. But good job. You got it. Kevin Malone. Another just iconic character. Alrighty. Quote number 16. I love catching people in the act. That's why I always whip open doors. Sean.
Dwight.
Dwight. Sean, you are making a comeback right now.
Tell
things
me
are getting heated. Quote number 17. I got 500 feet of red wire at a flea market. Adriana.
Dwight.
Dwight is incorrect for the steal.
Creed.
Creed is also incorrect. It's Jim. It was a...
Prank.
Pranky yeah, prank. It's okay. Right. You had the scenario going.
That's true.
So that's okay.
Yeah,
we have more, though. It's okay. Quote number 18. Presents are the best way to show someone how much you care. It's like a tangible thing you can point to and say, hey, man, I love you this many dollars worth. Adriana.
Michael.
Michael is correct. Dang, you guys are so... good, I can't even deal. Like, how do you know all these quotes?
We watch The Office.
We do, we love the show.
Like the show, Gina.
Like, how many times have you guys watched this?
A lot.
Six, and how many do you have?
Twice.
Two, okay. Ooh, okay.
Hey, it's just a good month. I'm like, it's a good month and
honestly,
a half to get through that show.
It
I'm
is.
Like, it's dedication.
Yeah, I think I've been through, I think I'm on fourth right now.
It's the grind.
It's so good.
I spent 12 hours watching it straight one time, and you know what? It was the best decision
that
of my
life. That is a quality day. Alrighty.
Quality day, honestly.
Well, let's see. Then you should all know this one. Quote number 19, save Bandit. Adriana.
Angela,
of course.
Save Bandit.
Alrighty, guys, we are on our very last quote. One day, Michael came in complaining about a speed bump on the highway. I wonder who he hit that time.
Jim
is correct. Dang, guys, we already ran through the round with extra time to spare. You guys just know your quotes. Alrighty, now before I tell who the big winner of the show is, do you guys have anything you want to promote while you're here? Any clubs?
Cinema Workshop.
Cinema Workshop.
I am the secretary for Cinema Workshop. We meet every Thursday in King Auditorium and we make movies. We have a fest coming up, which is the Lars Fest. So come on down every Thursday at 9:30 p.m. and you'll see me.
Beautiful. Cinema Workshop. Sean, anything?
Just got to promote RTN, all the studio shows, On the Couch, News, All Access. They're great shows. Check them out on YouTube and sports on the live stream as well. We do a lot of great stuff.
Beautiful. Yes, RTN and Cinema Workshop, awesome clubs. Definitely everybody should join them. Guys, this has been very, very intense episode, but our winner of the episode is Adriana. Adriana, you are going home with some awesome prizes. You have an eraser that says not again, because I feel like that's just like what we think every time Michael does anything. Got some office supplies and a Kit Kat bars because they're always taking breaks. And yes, thank you guys so much for being on the show. We loved
thank
having you.
Gina, thank such you, such a great time.
I'm
thank
glad you.
You
guys had fun. Thanks for watching Rowan Roulette, and we'll see you next time.